Hi Dilip sir, welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for doing this interview.
Thank you for asking one. Yeah, my pleasure.
Sir, first I wanted to ask you, pardon for my English. My English is not that great. I'm from Bengal, so my English is not that great.
So please, as long as we just communicate.
Yeah. So I just wanted to ask you that when you're remaking a film, which is already so popular, so what kind of pressure do you have? Because I have some friends in Chennai. When Bangalore Days was remade into Tamil, they didn't like it so much. And in case Drishyam also, they preferred the original word. I'm not saying that the Kamal Haasan version is not that bad, but they preferred the original one. So because Tamil is already a very popular film, it's very like critically acclaimed also. So what was the pressure on you while you're remaking it?
Actually, I didn't feel any pressure back then when I started off. One of the main reasons I think like this is my debut, which is one main reason. And secondly, I was very sure like we weren't trying to recreate the very vibe of Charlie. So Charlie appealed to me, like both the character and the film appealed to me for the free-spirited vibe it was going for. I really enjoyed it. It kept me hooked. It kind of kept me with the film. Like the vibe look to it, that it was pouring out of the screen, and it kept me attached to the film. And I knew like these are whenever there is a mood based film, like there are a lot of things that happens, like a lot of things that that goes beyond just writing. Okay. There are performances and the vibe each character carries, and a lot of these things. So, and I was very like back then I was sure that we are not going for the same vibe. If we are trying to recreate the same essence, like what I enjoyed, we are going to just be chasing that same thing, what we enjoyed and how to recreate it, rather trying to find a different film within that same space and put that out. That was my excitement, and we were just going behind that.
Okay. So now coming to my second question, that when I saw Mara, I have seen Charlie. When I saw Mara, I found that what you're telling now, that it's a very different film. So actually the character is also very different. You made it more human. I found Charlie was like more like a fancy film. It was like a godlike structure, like a character, but you made Mara more human, and your film is a bit longer than Charlie also. Then you've made a lot of changes to the characters, to the backstory and everything. So it is, we can't call it as a remake. So
right.
It's more of an adaptation, like how a book is translated into a film. So it's more of that. So can you please take us through the writing process when you're writing it? And when you are doing, like, your film is almost 15 to 20 minutes longer than the original version. So can you please tell us about that?
So about the time length, I don't think I have to... I have anything to add to that, because when you're making a film, when you're not even trying to retain the script, retain the characters of another film, retain the plot points of that other film, then the if you aren't going behind any of that, then I think like it's self-explanatory that you're never checking the comparing the length of your film with the other one.
Okay.
So that was never, even at the edit stage, like even while delivering it, that was never in mind. So you are making something else. And as of writing is concerned, I think it all started with like what we wanted to do with the remake.
Like
we are all cynical about remakes. I also belong to a generation like where why do you want to recreate something that already had an impact? But but that's the whole fun, right? Like when you're throwing stones at something continuously, and then when you are asked to do something like that, then either you run away from it or you have some fun with it.
Okay.
So I think like for me it was an opportunity, and I wanted to get on, like grab that opportunity, make the best out of it, but also not just remake it, rather try to see like what I can do with it. Like if we were just trying to change the scenes or rewrite the scenes or rewrite the just the conversations, then that becomes I thought like it's a change for the sake of it.
Okay.
So rather what if we are going for a change in the story itself? So by that, what you're doing is you're taking one you're taking an existing story and saying that and trying to do something something that would finally reflect as there is an other story that could be weaved within the same premise. You know, like that's what interested me, and I tried to do that, and thankfully it resonated with the production house, with Mr. Madhavan, and able to do that.
So I have heard that when you are signed, already R. Madhavan was on board. So
right.
When you're writing, keeping the actor in mind, and you know that you have seen his films, and you know so that act as an added advantage. Do you think that?
It added more clarity.
Okay.
Yeah. Of like you know whom you are doing it for.
Okay.
So and you have also grown up. Watching his films, you know him. You know him from all the characters that he has done before, and you know like what are the characters in which like you really liked him, like he really worked. Like his character. There are some characters of his that has worked for me. Really well, and there are these other characters which you are like okay. It's I prefer the other one, the other face of this actor than this one, than these characters. Like you know, like you can attach one person to certain characters, and maybe other characters of his that he has played are not your favorites. So you're trying to play around with what you have liked, and not just stop there. But also you're looking at like where you can go from there.
Okay. So, can I ask you, which are your favorite Madhavan film? Like our Madhavan films, favorite?
Anbeshwam is one of my favorite films. And Minnale is another favorite film of his. Like when, and I'm speaking about his characters. Yeah. So in Minnale, I like this character a lot. And yeah, and Kannathil Muthamittal, I really like them in Kannathil Muthamittal.
Okay.
So, yeah, Madhavan doesn't agree with me on that, but still, yeah, that's one character I've really enjoyed. Yeah.
So now coming to this technical part, your film has a great cinematography and art direction, which gives it that kind of a fairy tale, because you wanted to create that kind of zone. Like a treasure hunt kind of zone. So I have stolen this treasure hunt kind of zone from Bharadwaj Rangan sir's review, this treasure hunt part. But the cinematography is actually helping a lot to tell you the story. So can you please take us through that journey, that how, when you're designing this particular like shots and aesthetics and everything, can you please take us through that journey?
I don't know exactly like what, like how to put it in like a couple of sentences and tell you that like it is. We have decided that I had decided the free spirit is not the keyword that Mara associates itself with, like as a film. Mara doesn't associate itself with just free spirit. Maybe free spirit is in there, in the characters, in the choices that they make. But that's not what the film stands for. And rather it's a, you know, like we all have these, we all come across these stories in real life. Yeah, some people tell us, or like we always hear some really impossible stories from our relatives, from our friends, of like, you know what, like this happened to this person, can you even believe? Okay, like that. And it, like when you listen to those stories, like it seems very impossible. Like it almost feels like it's made up, right? So with lots of coincidences and things like that. So I was going for something like that. Like I thought like, okay, so we will, our story is the story that we are weaving in, like on top of Charlie. That's kind of an impossible story. And it has a larger, one larger arc, and there are a lot of characters in it, and all these characters are as a shade to it, like shade in the sense like they all have a certain quirks, and that's adding a certain hue to it, right? Like each character if it's a color spectrum, then each character is one color, somewhat one color. So when, and all these I associated with fairy tales. Like fairy tales have a very impossible story. It has a number of characters. Right from the most basic fairy tale, like Alice in Wonderland. Like if Mara is called Alice in Wonderland, then what would be the treatment like? But you can't animate it. You can't, like we also decided, like you can't go all the way. It's not a Tim Burton film. It's somewhere in, everything is set in reality. But, and these are places like where, most probably like there are places like where you might have already been to, or like it's, And there are scenes like which are set in places that you are very familiar with in spirit. Like for example, an antique shop. An antique shop is something we all would have visited in some, even whether you are a collector or not. Like you definitely know what the antique shop looks like, right? So when you're going for these settings, then you're trying to see what. How are you gonna give it a slight twist to make it seem give that a fairy tale tone to it, so that the whole film can stick to one tone, like the tonality by tonality. I don't mean the palette. I'm not getting into specifics like color palettes any such thing, but the tonality of the film itself. And here I would say like the tone here we have gone for is like how to set this world somewhere between fantasy and on that blurry line between fantasy and reality.
Okay.
So yeah, I mean like that kind of dictated everything from the colors to the lensing and things like that. And I had the two brilliant cinematographers who could take it and who could see like what can be done towards it. I think like we pulled off a decent job there. And yeah. And Ajay Chaliseri, who is our production designer, he is phenomenal. And his body, his work, like he is an artist himself. And also he is a Malayali who is very familiar with Charlie, who loves Charlie. And so now you hand over a script like this to him, instead of giving him the film Charlie and tell him that okay, we are going to recreate this, so why don't you make a house, why don't you make a commune, why don't you make these set pieces. Instead of that, we handed him over the script, the new script, and asked him to, and also told him these things of what, okay, Charlie went behind creating this vibe, but yeah, we are going behind something else. So why don't we, yeah, what would you do with it? Was the brief. So, and he's exemplary. So yeah, at what he does. And yeah, I mean, like, it's just with these great technicians, you're in safe hands, you know, right? Like, when you're, mm-hmm. when you have technicians like who are phenomenal with their craft, and also like when during the initial sessions, when you are when you have successfully conveyed them what you are trying to do, what at least to an extent, if you have conveyed it, if you have communicated it, then half the job is done there. Then it is all about
sir, thank you so much. I will just, this is the last question that I will ask. Your first film, that the there is a short film that you have made, I've seen, like, it's on Netflix called Kalki. So it's a love story. It's placed in a genre of science fiction, and Mara is also a different kind of a love story. So if you're told to make one more love story, so which genre you're going to put it into? Like,
no, I didn't see it in that way at all. Like,
okay.
Which genre would I pocket a love story into? Yeah. Okay, just if I have to answer that question, then I think I would love to do a love story. This is not a love story, but then Silence of the Lambs. If Silence of the Lambs were a love story.
Okay.
Because there is that, yeah, I think right now, as I'm telling you, this is like, yeah, it's for the first time that somebody had asked me a question like that.
Okay.
And it made me think, and I'm also surprised I could think of Silence of Lambs. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. It's quite a surprise. Thank you for getting that out of me. And yeah.
And I will be very happy if you actually make one like that. Thank you so much, sir, for doing this.
Thank you.
I won't take much of your time. You're already busy with a lot of interviews and all. And like, I know that Mara is already getting a lot of positive response. And I'm very sure that people from our part, like from East India and West Bengal, a lot of people will watch it, and they all will also love it. Thank you so much.
Thanks to you. And this is I was actually looking forward to this interview. Though I was not punctual. Sorry about that.
No problem. Yeah,
just a day's release, and then things are like little haywire here. But then I definitely wanted to do this because like totally in love with the cinema and music that comes from your part of the country.
Okay.
That it's a huge fan of.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Bye.